Hi viewers, this is Meenakshi from Maxito. Welcome to my channel. You are watching Ganesh Tutorials. Are you ready to learn? Let me start the class. In this video, I am going to solve the problem. Exercise 4.1, second problem, subdivision number 4, chapter 4, 10th standard NCERT maths. Actually, what they given in this problem? They given a situation. We should represent the situation into quadratic equation form. So the situation is here. A train travels a distance of 480 kilometers at a uniform speed. If the speed had been 8 kilometers per hour less, then it would have taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. We need to find the speed of the train. Okay, again I will explain. The trains travel a distance 480 kilometers at a uniform speed. Here we don't know the speed and the time, but they given the distance. Are you all clear? Actually, they given a distance is 480. Then uniform speed. So uniform speed also we don't know what it is. So just we can take it as a uniform speed as a x. And we need to find the time. Clear? So in the first condition, the distance 480, speed x, we should find the time t. Right? Clear? I will explain how to find the time. We know the relation between these three, right? So, using this relation to find the time. Okay, listen, I will explain. If the speed had been 8 km per hour less. So, second condition, the speed has been reduced there 8 km per hour, right? Then it would be take 3 hours more to cover the same distance. So, the same distance 480, it will take the time to cover 3 hours more. Clear? Then we need to find the speed and speed of the train. Clear? So here we don't know the uniform speed in the first condition, right? A train travels distance of 480 km at a uniform speed. So we don't know the uniform speed, so we can take that is a x. So x be the speed of the train. Clear? Then distance. So the first condition, distance what they given, that is 480 km per hour. Then we need to find the time. Very well clear, the time taken. So we know the relation speed is equal to distance by time. So now we from this you should find out the time. So time is equal to distance by speed. Clear? Time is equal to distance by speed. So now time is equal to what is the distance? 480. Then speed. We take this as x. So x. Clear? Hours. It is the first condition. So second condition, what they said, if the speed had been 8 km less. So speed 8 km less, it means speed is equal to x minus 8. It is the second condition, right? Here it is first condition over, which is marked as small one. So speed, second condition speed, it is the speed had been 8 km less. That is x minus 8. Then it will take 3 hours more to cover the same distance. So it will take 3 hours more. So time. So time in this is equal to 480 usual time. It will take 3 hours more. So plus 3 hours. Clear? Any doubt? 3 hours more to cover the same distance. Same distance 480. We need to find the speed of the train. Clear? Any doubt? So from the second condition, we know that speed they given, time also they given, distance also they given, that is t. So speed into time is equal to distance, right? Actually, from this I just find out speed into time is equal to distance. So now we can apply this here. So what is the speed here? X minus 8. Then time. They given 480 divided by x plus 3. Then which is equal to distance. What is the distance? 480. So from the problem, what is the speed we find out? That is x minus 8. Clear? Into time 480 by x plus 3. Clear? Equal to distance. Distance, what it is? 480. Same distance. Clear? It is a more important problem. Now we can use the distributive property to multiply. Right? Are you all clear? Now, x into the first term, x into this one and x into 3. So, x into 480, 480x divided by x
plus 3 into x, 3x, then minus into 8 into this term. So 8 into 480 divided by x, right? Then minus into 8, 2 is a 16, 3 is a 24, equal to 480. Clear? Any doubt? Next, x, x cancel. So remaining 480 plus 3x. Now you just multiply 8 into 480. So minus 800, 88 is 64, 4 remaining 6, 48 is 32, 32 plus 6 is 38. So divided by x minus 24 equal to 480. Clear? Any doubt? Now we should take a LCM for this number because x here, right? So now you can take here 3x minus 3840 divided by x. Then you should segregate, a constant should be in a same side. So plus 480 minus 24. You just bring this also constant, right? So minus 480 equal to 0. First you can solve the constant, that is 3x minus 3840 divided by x plus, right? You can solve it now. So it is the same symbols, minus minus. First you can add it, 480 minus 480 minus 24. So 4, 0, remaining 1, 5. So minus 5, 40. 5 minus 5, 4, 5, 0, 4. Clear? Now it is a different sign. So subtraction, 480. Subtracted, here 4, here 10, 2, here 4. So 24. So plus minus 24. Larger number is minus, so minus 24 equal to 0. Clear? Now you should take LCM. X here you can take x as a LCM. So 3 into x square minus 3840. Are you all know how it is x square? Here there is no number. So I want to make this denominator as a x. So I can multiply numerator and denominator as a x variable. So 3 into x square minus, this is the same one, minus here 24x equal to 0. Clear? Then 3x square minus 3840 minus 24x equal to 0 into x. It is a divided one. It will go to the right side, become a 0 into x, 0 into x, 0. So 3x square minus 24x minus 3840 equal to 0, right? Now we find out the, we represented the given situation into quartic equation form. Clear? Any doubt? It is a more important problem. Real clear?
I hope in this video you make clear about the problem. Thank you for watching my video. If it is any doubt, you can ask me in a comment.